bills, then he has no responsibilities there. I mean, so for the to punish the head coach, to me it was kind of like a setup. So they're saying since Zach Smith is on Coach Meyer's staff, we're going to punish Coach Meyer and see if it affects his team. Now, considering how talented Coach Urban Meyer's team is, I don't really see his absence having that much of an effect because they're just that talented. But in the same respect, you can't punish the head coach. Right. He has nothing to do with this. This is a situation that happened in Zach Smith's home.
Yeah.
Coach Urban's name is nowhere on any bills, which, I mean, I hope not. I don't know the situation. Let me not speak out of context here. But you're punishing him for something that has nothing to do with him. I mean, he's not even associated in any way. I mean, now, if it's something that happened with the team,
then
you go to the head coach. But this is in another household that has nothing to do with Coach Meyer. So I don't agree with that. I think it's a setup to just, you know, knock them out of national contention for a championship or anything like that. And I honestly myself don't see that happening because, I mean, they're one of the top talented teams in the nation.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, here's my view of it. Now it's one thing if this was happening at the athletic facilities, you know, where everybody was. But usually a wife don't come around there unless it's a family event or family gathering.
Exactly.
And my first reasoning is, you know, why text Urban's wife? Why not go to the police?
Right.
And why not, you know, press charges and do that rather than go to Urban's wife?
Right. And, I mean, there are plenty hotline numbers that you can also contact as well regarding this situation. So, I mean, she reached out. She just reached out to the wrong person. Mm-hmm. I mean, you can't really control what anybody talks about as far as conversation. Maybe she just felt that closeness to speak with Coach Meyer's wife about this. And if that's the case, I mean, I guess she has that right. But, I mean, still at the end of the day, you know, talk to the person or the company or the entity that can help you with this. And in this situation is not his wife. If anything, the wife should have probably said, okay, well, let's call the National Domestic Abuse Hotline and let's get you some help. But to just, you know, people to come in and just, you know, punish Urban Meyer the way they did.
You know, I mean, I don't like Urban Meyer. I mean, I don't have nothing against him. I mean, I think he's a good coach, but that's about it. But, you know, to suspend him for 3 games is rather lucrative. I mean, it shows – you know, the state of the country, where the country is, and I don't mean to get political on this show, but nowadays, you know, people are easily offended instead of just taking a joke.
Right, and I don't know. I'm just anxious to see, you know, number one, what happens with this situation, the state of the Buckeyes after, you know, during this situation as well. Like I said, I don't think it's going to affect the team by any means because Coach Urban Meyer, he's known for putting a great staff together. And, you know, just, you know, for him to not be on the sideline, I mean, he'd probably be in the athletic department. I mean, I'm also intrigued about the mindset of the team as well. But, you know, they're still going to go out there, play. They're going to do their job. I'm pretty sure they're just going to, you know, block this situation out of their head through the duration of the game. And I'm sure they have their coach's best interest at heart. But I don't agree with this at all. And I just can't wait till it's over and, you know, Coach Urban is back on the sideline with his team.
You're exactly right. Well, that does it for this segment. We're going to take a break with a little Tom Sawyer. And then we're going to come back and we're going to talk fantasy football. It'll be Kinsley, me, and Evan. So that should be really fun. Y'all stay tuned for that, and we'll be right back. And again, thank you to Central Sunbelt Federal Credit Union and Laurel Home Center. We'll be right back, folks.
Mean pride.
Yo.
All right, welcome back, everybody. We're coming to you live from Laurel Home Center, where they're trying to get all rid of their 2018s and bring in the 2019s on the lot. Kinsley, it's a great staff. Why don't you tell them who all they can see there when they come by and talk to the good folks here?
You can come up here and you can talk to Evan, Blake, Colton, Daniel, Susan, Hillary. So many different people you can talk to, and I can guarantee you're going to have a great experience with either one of them. So if you come up here and you're looking for a home, there's no reason why you shouldn't come away with one. You can come visit them at 5185 Highway 84 West in Laurel. You can contact them at 601-428-8218. And you can also visit them online at www.laurelhomecenter.com. So come on down to Laurel Home Center. Come on, get you a good home.
Hey, I did. I've got one. We're just waiting waiting for the contract now.
I mean, you know what, John? Every time you talk about this place, I can always sense the excitement in your voice.
Yeah,
I mean, hey.
We're ready to get it. we're ready to get it. And I tell you, speaking of Laurel Home Center, we're going to have a challenge. The Laurel Home Center Family Fantasy Football Challenge, where you pay $15 to get in the league. And you win, $240?
Yep.
Okay. So, come by, pay Hillary $15. We need 8 more people to join. So, $15, Hillary Smith up here at our Susan. She'll take your money and put it in the safe. So, come on by and see them. Check out a house. Colton, what kind of deals have you guys got going on right now? Because I know, it's getting ready to move out some trailers and move in some new ones.
Right. Well, right now we got a few off the lot here. We're trying to blow out some of our lots. So our inventory right now, we got about 50, 60 homes here. So I know Evan, he's the manager here now, and he's trying to discount them off the lot, just get them gone. That being said, nothing's wrong with them. We just had been ordering off those homes. So we're trying to get them out of here and get something newer in here.
All right. So you heard it there. So now we're going to talk a little fantasy football and then wrap up the show. That's kind of a big deal. It's calling, a lot here as of late. And so you're going into a fantasy football draft like a lot of us will be here in the coming weeks to start the new NFL season off. And not Evan, but Colton. Okay, Colton. Tell me this. Who is your first pick? What kind of a player would you want to draft in your first round? And what round would you really – what place would you want to pick at? What would be the thing that you would say?
Well, honestly, I'm new to fantasy football. We just had our I'm in another league with some buddies. We just had our draft Thursday night. And, man, it was fun. I ain't never did it before, but I'm definitely going to get into it, and I can't wait for our draft. But – So I had pick number 5, and honestly, that's right there in the middle. We had a 10.
Yeah, that's a good pick.
Yeah, we had a 10-guy league. So what fell to me, I was really looking to target Antonio Brown for round 1, but sadly he went to the guy that had the 4th pick right before me. So, but I got Ezekiel Elliott, so I ain't too bent out of shape about it. But, yeah, I'm excited about it. I think I got a pretty good team.
Okay, that is a good pick. Zeke will always get you some points. Now, me, I kind of go after a quarterback the first round. And the quarterback that really stands out to me is Dak Prescott. There's a guy that can throw the football, run the football, get you touchdowns when you need him to, and is a real solid athlete. And that's somebody that I would get in the first round. So that's who I would go after. Kinsley, what about you?
Well, I'm like you, John. The quarterback, I mean, that's the main person in the offense. So going quarterback, I mean, hey, me being a Saints fan, I'm gonna select Drew Brees. Not being biased here, but I mean, he's just a good quarterback. He has a great surrounding staff. I mean, Michael Thomas, Ted Ginn, they also have Cameron Meredith. So I mean, he's gonna put some stats up this year. So that would be my first pick.
Okay, yeah, that's a good pick too. Now, Colton, if you were looking for a running back, who would be a good quality running back you would use?
A running back, as far as this year, it being his first year, so I'm real high on Christian McCaffrey. I mean, he can do it all. He's going to catch some passes for you. He's going to run the ball, and he's quick as lightning. And he also may get you some returns on a kickoff. I don't know if he's doing punt returns this year, but I mean, I really like Christian McCaffrey this year.
Okay, that's a good pick too. Now, I would go after Devontae Freeman. There's a guy.
Yeah, he'd be solid.
He would be a solid pick and can really run the football and really the go-to guy on the Falcons offense. He kind of does everything for the Falcons, and so that's who I would pick.
For sure.
Kinsley?
Okay. So, my pick would be Marshawn Lynch. Now, I'm more of a – when it comes to running backs, I'm more of a speed-type guy. But, I mean, Marshawn Lynch, he does have speed, but he also packs some power, too. I mean, that guy's a relentless runner.
Okay.
So, and I think the Raiders are going to do some good things this year. So, I'm going with Marshawn Lynch.
Can't go wrong with beast mode.
Oh, no.
So that's a good pick. So, I'm going to tell you, for wide receiver, the first wide receiver I would get is a fellow by the name of DeAndre Hopkins out of Houston. Now, there's a guy that can go up and play and can really make a difference out on the field. So that's who I would choose. Kinsley, what about you?
Hey, I'm going with Antonio Brown. I mean, the guy has everything you would want in a receiver. The guy's like, he's fast as lightning, and the guy has hands. I mean, if the ball is going his direction, he's going to come down with it.
All right. How about you, Colton?
Yeah, I agree. I like Antonio Brown, but in this past draft, like I said, he was gone, so I got Hopkins, actually, Big John. I mean, I'm excited about him. But another guy I want to mention is Michael Thomas for the Saints. I mean, he's going to be number one receiver. He's going to get plenty of targets. I mean, he's going to do really good for him.
Like your style.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so there we go. We've got our wide receivers now. Let's talk a little tight ends. Now, a lot of people would go after Gronkowski up at New England, which is not a bad pick. That's a really good pick. But I would go with a fella in Philadelphia by the name of Zach Ertz. He's really come on for the Eagles. He's a guy that can be counted on, and the Eagles like to pass it around a little bit. So I would go with Ertz for tight end. Colton, what about you?
For sure. Well, I really like Travis Kelce out of Kansas City. I mean, top two, maybe top three tight ends. Him and Gronk right there neck and neck. I really like Kelce.
Okay, so it's really good young picks. And, John, I kind of was thinking about Zach Ertz too. So he's a good young guy, but one guy, veteran guy that I really like is Jimmy Graham. I liked him when he was with the Saints. Now he's reunited with Aaron Rodgers in Green Bay. And, you know, from seeing Graham in the preseason, the guy looks like he's going to make a difference with them as well, because he's going to be a top target. Big guy, tall, has speed. So, I mean, hey, I think it's going to be a great compliment.
Yeah, I agree. I think that is really a good compliment. So let's go to the flex player. Now, you're going to have a lot of different flex players. Some are going to be running back. Some are going to be wide receiver, quarterback even, I think, for a flex. But I'm going to tell you who I would pick. If he's still on the board by the time you get to your flex player, I'm going to pick the guy out of LSU that's playing for the Jacksonville Jaguars, who's really been running the football, and Leonard Fournette. I think he's a big difference maker, and I think he could get some points too, because the Jaguars, they're more of a West Coast style of offense where they run the football, then they play action pass, and if they don't get down there within the goal line, they're going to run the football. So I like Leonard Fournette for the Jaguars.